Let's make my steps a little bit larger so I can get up there again. And what I'm thinking of doing here is I'm thinking of using these steps to start creating a sloping, slightly pointy roof.
Okay.
So it's going to be interesting to see how this goes. You know, this bit, for example, it's not going to work very well, I think. But there's ways and means. We just have to try a few things out.
Okay. Well, I'm having an issue filling in this one section in the center. It's looking... There we go. Filled it in.
Well done.
Like a boss. This little area over here dips down too much. I can't get under there. Okay.
I think I need here is some scaffolding. So let's make some quickly.
Nope.
I had the ability to walk around here without plummeting to my death.
Yeah, that's ideal.
Plummeting to my death is ideal.
Yeah.
When did we get married?
I didn't mean it that way.
I know.
Okay. Oh. Hi. All right.
Oh, I have an idea. Yes, I have an idea. Right.
Do you now?
Whoop. I do. I does indeed. Ideas. I does have one.
You sound a little more awake than you were before. So.
I think it's probably the fact I've been talking for the past hour.
Yeah, that would make sense.
There. Yes, that looks quite nice. Okay, that looks all right.
Fill in.
We'll do the same here as well. So, that one.
Sorry to everyone for my terrible water filling in abilities. Or inabilities, I suppose.
Okay, that looks majorly horrible. Why did that go wrong? Let's take that one out, put it back in again.
I think you're a little too hard on yourself.
No, that did actually look quite horrible.
Oh, okay. Fair enough. Wow, I would love for that to fill in too. Okay.
Ooh. I think I'm not going to fight that one. What I'm going to do is... Oh, I see. It's getting confused by these two here. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm just going to take these ones out. Just put some blocks in instead. And I think that'll look all right from the ground.
Okay. I actually wanted to ask you a question now that I'm thinking about it.
Uh-huh.
If I punch a chest that has stuff in it to break it down, does the stuff stay in it?
No.
Oh.
It scatters around across the floor.
Crud, that.
So if you want to get rid of those chests, we're probably going to have to team up and do it quite quickly.
No, it's okay. The chests are fine. I was thinking about it for my own house because I have to transport stuff and I'm super lazy.
Okay. Yeah. Oh. Yes. Well, I don't think any of us would be doing trying to make a career out of talking into a microphone while playing games if we weren't super lazy.
Well, I mean, to be fair, this is pretty much the only option I had, but it's not exactly difficult.
Well, to be fair, I'm super lazy.
Nuh-uh.
No, it's pretty fair to say I'm super lazy. I'm a computer programmer by trade, or at least I used to be. I quit my job recently, and... not to do YouTube, I've got to point out, because I make absolutely nothing out of this. I don't monetize my videos or anything like that. But there's a gentleman by the name of Larry Wall, quite a famous programmer, came up with the virtues of a programmer, which are laziness, impatience, and hubris. Yeah, laziness. I'm too lazy to keep on doing this 4-hour task every day, so I'm going to write a computer program that will do it in 20 minutes for me. It might take me 20 hours to do it, but over a few weeks I will make a saving. Impatience? Why hasn't somebody done this? I'll do it anyway. And hubris? I am the best person to do this job. There you go. The virtues of a programmer.
Nice.
Yes.
Fair enough.
And... Yeah, as they were probably set up by somebody who is lazy, impatient, and quite egotistical, it makes a lot of sense, really, doesn't it?
I suppose.
Right, let's get rid of these. Don't need these anymore. Like that. And like that. Don't need that. Not entirely sold that this roof is going to work well. I might have to. I might do something with slabs instead.
Okay.
But, sometimes you can't actually work it out for yourself until you're actually looking at it. And let's look at it from the top. Let's kind of get a bird's eye view. In fact, I don't think I've done a bird's eye view of spawning. Well, this is only a few week old server, but it's changing every week. It's really quite amazing how much it changes all the time.
Only a few weeks? That's bananas.
Mm. Yeah. I started this second week in October.
Yeah. Okay. Nice. Oh, whoops. This actually goes up a little too high. Oh, well.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, well.
That zombie's never going to get to you.
Well, you know what? Too bad for him.
So, okay, let's have a quick walk around here, because there's so much new here. The tree farm is looking really good. I've put some jungle trees in there. I don't know how well they're going to farm, but we'll see.
Yeah, looks good.
Over there, crap. You can see in the back.
Sorry. Get away from me.
That's all the sheep. There's a little wheat farm there to feed them and breed them. There's April's house, and it looks absolutely fantastic from the top as well.
Thank you.
Hellcat's house, with her eclectic group of multicolored sheep.
Well, you know,
and
you gotta...
wall of cocoa beans, yes. And Clucking Good Chicken, which looks even worse from the top. The Halloween special, that's only going to be there till probably the weekend. I'll take that down and we'll think of something else. It's Guy Fawkes Bonfire Night in this country on the 5th. So I might do something about that. I'm not entirely certain what, but we decided we're going to keep that little corner there for celebrations. So, yeah, sort of Halloween, Christmas.
It'll be like in Animal Crossing.
Yeah, that sort of thing. So occasionally I'm going to do a build there, which is going to be seasonally themed, or you know, somebody else might do it. We'll see how it goes with that. The library, and I've got to be honest with you, I don't like that roof, so I think I'm going to do something else.
Okay.
And my house, which is pretty much unchanged, apart from the fact the fields are getting larger.
Yeah, your fields are massive.
Yeah. I should imagine eventually it's going to spread down to the river there, but there's going to be a limit there, because if you look over in this corner here, Hell Kitty has started a build project over here, this lit up area. Nice regimented stripes. Oh, it's nice. Like she mowed the lawn. It's going to be a cathedral.
Ah.
Right, so, yeah, so... looking at a few designs, and there's a fairly impressive one she wants to do. So there's going to be a little road across the front here. If you follow my cursor, she's going to build behind it, and the road is going to cut across my land down here and likewise across here and join the road there. So that's going to give a boundary to the spawn village itself, but the roads are going to carry on up there, and the roads are going to carry on up there, and well, basically for all the cardinal directions. So at least out to about, I'm thinking about going about 300, 400 blocks out from spawn. That's probably large enough.
Probably, yeah. Feel badly. Everybody's just watching me fill this with water.
Yeah, why not?
Yeah.
Including everyone. Everyone's watching on my channel is now watching you fill this with water. Yeah. What do you think? Is she gonna get washed away?
Probably. And then I'm gonna then I'm gonna swear a bunch, which I don't want to do on your channel. So.
Oh, why not? Everyone else does.
I hear a zombie. Get away.
I mean, I play a couple of other games with some guys who are from a group of YouTubers called Team Tuxedo.
Oh yeah.
And they're absolutely great guys, but their language is not, let's say, perfect. But that's all part of the fun, really.
I suppose. Yeah, I have a tremendous potty mouth. Although I try to keep that under wraps on my channel, too. I don't always succeed, but, you know, I think the effort counts for something.
Yeah. Well, I swear I do apologize.
Well, you're so kind and polite.
Oh, she knows me so little.
You should look at it from the front, because I've got a cascade going. I'm still filling in some stuff, but it's actually looking kind of neat.
Sometimes these little swirly bits, because of the Minecraft physics, are really frustrating to deal with, but you'll get there. But I do like this.
Yeah, I think it's going to look really cool. I'll probably adjust it a little bit, but it's like, it's very soothing too.
that middle bit where you've got a little block of green.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I gotta fill that in.
Okay, I know. I was actually thinking perhaps if we put a little bit more earth around it and made a little island.
Yeah,
there.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
Yeah, and then the water could flow around it either side.
Kind of like
in nice.
Niagara Falls, where the Canadian side has like a little wedge down the middle.
Yeah, that sort of thing. And put some flowers and that. We might even put a bridge out to it later on, so people can walk out there. But yeah, let's see how it goes. I like that. That's really nice.
Damn it.
Now let's go back and look at something I don't like so much.
Damn it. Oh boy. There's this one little hole up here that's driving me bonkers. Okay.
I don't need any of that. Let's get some more bricks, though. There we go. Stone bricks. I want to make some slabs. And I want to try making the roof out of this slabs. I like the color of these slabs, which I think works quite well.
Which ones?
But, the brick ones.
Oh, okay.
That are on the base here. The polished stone slabs, which are the way that I've made the walls out of, are a slightly different colour. So I just want to go back to that darker colour again for the roof, just for some contrast.
Yeah. It's going to look good.
I certainly hope so.
I keep looking up at my fraps like, oh man, if you crash, I swear. Giving fraps the stink eye. Oh man, come on. Come on. Sorry everybody for the bobbing. Hopefully my reticle that Simon made is helping you.
I'm just really glad that's where it's working out for us.
Yeah, I got so motion sick before. It was really bad.
Mm. Yeah, I didn't think, in all honesty, I was going to see you come back here again because of that. That was really quite terrible for you.
Yeah, it
wasn't
was. It? I get really motion sick. It's bad. Except on planes, I'm fine on planes, but otherwise. Can't even ride in the back seat of a car.
That's a good excuse.
Yeah. So I always get to ride shotgun. Which, as a 32-year-old, well, 31, almost 32-year-old woman, I shouldn't care about, but I will admit that I do.
I was thinking of that. Somebody's got a birthday tomorrow.
Yeah, you should all go over to XM Sugar's channel or on her Twitter and say happy birthday to her. I think she's turning the same age that I am. I don't know if she's a little older than me.
Well, actually, she's had a birthday and you're all the same age.
Oh, yep, so.
Yeah. She's actually, as we are recording, it is the 5th of November. It is her birthday. So by the time this comes out, it's probably a couple of days past. But go to her channel and say happy birthday.
She'll love it.
Yeah.
Laura loves hearing from people. So do we. You should totes comment on this video.
Absolutely. Absolutely. First of all, I love talking to people, as you probably noticed. And secondly, it just helps.
That's great, yeah.
Yeah, YouTube look at comments. It doesn't actually have to be a good comment. YouTube looks at likes, dislikes, and says, yeah, hey, people are paying attention to this.
Pretty much any interaction.
So, yeah, let's go and bump them up. Let's get them some people looking at them, because they're either really good or really offensive. And to YouTube, it doesn't really matter which.
Yeah, ultimately. Which is a shame.
Yeah, but
sometimes it can be.
Yeah, so comments are great. Likes are great. Dislikes, from YouTube's point of view, are great, but they make people cry.
Yeah, I used to get a little sensitive about it, but now it's kind of like, well, thanks for the view.
Yeah.
But I guess that comes with age as well.
Indeed. As speaking of the oldest one of the group by far, I'm not going to talk about that.
You're not that old.
No, I'm just a little bit older than you.
Although
guys.
You're Laura's father figure, I guess. Yeah, don't worry about it.
No, I'm not in the slightest. It is amusing. How am I going to do this? All right, first of all, I'm going to get rid of all this earth. And probably this shovel, because it's about to
die. Man, I'm sorry, everybody. I'm trying to fill this in as like well as possible, and some of these are just being jerks.
But I will say this. It's really interesting looking down at this, looking at the water flowing through.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Optical.
I quite like this.
Check it out.
Yeah. Once we get some lighting down there.
Yeah, it's going to look nice.
Oh, jack-o'-lanterns would look really good
down
there.
Yeah, like even if you just put them along the side or underneath, too, if we put some glowstone to get a little bit of like an underwater lighting feature effect.
Mm-hmm.
Beauty.
Yeah, that's looking really good.
Yay.
We get some flowers and some bushes and some mushrooms perhaps would look good down there. Just liven it up a little bit.
Yeah, I'm excited.
Yeah. And I don't think the stuff I'm going to be doing is going to affect your river that much. I might have to fill in just a tiny little corner.
Yeah, what are we
going to
do?
But I hope
technically,
right.
This is still your town.
No, I may be the mayor, but it's a team effort. It's everyone working together.
Yeah, everybody's doing a great job. I look around at everybody's houses and places and buildings and stuff, and I'm like, oh, this is so inspiring.
Yeah. We've got some new people on, and they are coming on, and one of them especially is an exceptional builder, and I'm going to show off their stuff when it's a bit more ready. Certainly put my skills to shame, I
would
say.
Oh, yeah? Nice.
Yeah, so I'm looking forward to seeing those. And I've got a couple of builds in plan as well. Anyone who's played Fallout 3... will probably know of a place called Tenpenny Tower.
Yep.
If you don't know, go look it up. Because it's actually quite a magnificent looking building. And I've got a lot of factories and spawners and things like that that I wanted to build. And I wanted to wrap a building around them. And I was looking at that thinking, you know, that's the perfect design.
Yeah.
So over there, fairly soon, is going to be... You probably won't see it from here, but as you walk out of Spawn Village... You will be seeing Tenpenny Tower rearing its head up above these hills here.
Nice.
I'm going to have all my little factories and perhaps a little house on the roof there. And a lot of the things I do, the experimental stuff I do, will be going on in there. All the redstone building and that. Out of spawn, out of people's way. And it's going to be a place to go when you say, oh, I want... 2 stacks of gunpowder. Where can I go get it? You can go Tenpenny Tower.
Yay.
And pick it up.
It's gonna be good.
Which is something I could have used earlier on making those fireworks, because I had to spend about half a day doing really unpleasant things to creepers to get that much gunpowder.
What do you do?
Yeah, that's pretty much what the creepers said as well.
Well, you know.
Oh, well, I snaked up behind them and went chop.
Well, they're kind of jerkish, so. Yeah. Oh man, I need to make another. Actually, I need to dig another hole. I'll be able to eventually fill that in, though, right?
Yep.
Because yeah, I have to keep walking too far, so. And eventually I will get queasy. I think I need to eat, though. That's the big thing.
Perhaps we should take a short break.
Maybe, yeah. I'm pretty hungry. Let's see. Let's just get this filled in.
Oh, actually, that works all right, doesn't it? Because if we go get rid of that one, put one in there. Oh, that looks nice. Okay, so. It's very odd building a roof from the bottom, but it seems to be working.
Yeah. That's what I did with mine. I don't know. I was... excuse me. I was so fixated on it. I was like, I have to finish this. And the guys were like, you should go to sleep. And I was like, no.
sometimes you just got to do it. So, yeah. Okay, that actually works. That's a little low roof, but... I think it'll look all right, and it should look all right from the bottom now.
Oops,
as well.
I thought this wasn't gonna empty. Damn it. I did it incorrectly. Yeah. You said I had to do... Do I have to do all four opposite corners, or just two?
Okay, just two.
I did that, and then it emptied, because I must be bad at this. So, okay, there's one. Let's do this again. Yeah, this sounds so nice too. The water, it's all flowing.
Yeah, hopefully it'll be good. And it's a great fishing place, and we should be able to fill buckets from it all right. And everyone will be happy. Or at least less miserable.
I don't think anybody's miserable.
No, nobody's miserable except for possibly me on a Friday morning. But that's either me or Friday mornings. I'm not entirely certain which one, but it's one of them.
Friday mornings aren't so bad.
Yes. Let's stop talking and actually build something for a moment. Let's go and do the other corner there.
I feel like, seriously, sorry everybody who's watching my video. I'm just like, let me just build. Nothing. You just watch me fill this in.
It's all part of the fun. This is the joy of Minecraft. It's just playing with something and just experimenting, knowing that nothing you do is permanent, and you can make and you can create and you can have crazy designs.
True.
And just let your hair down and be creative. It's Lego on computers.
Yeah, I can see that. Wow, yeah, doing a bad job here. Okay, here we go. Oh, sometimes my music kicks in, and I'm like, where did this come from? I'm still really new to Minecraft, so I'm doing my best, though.
Yeah, you're doing an excellent job, I think. I got to be honest, one of the reasons why I first invited April and a few other people, and I hardly knew you guys then, didn't I, was I wanted to see what a simmer would do. Yeah, how well those skills would transfer.
Yeah, I mean, it seems to be working.
Yes.
It's been enjoyable. I mean, I would consider you a simmer. I mean, you've said that you build in the game, and...
Yeah, I've started laying out a Let's Play, which I promise people I'll get out before... Sims 5
eventually
comes out. Yeah, that's a promise. Okay, that is etched in stone. Okay, everyone who's listening to this, if I haven't done it by the time Sims 5 comes out,
that
you
is
can
a
tell
Simon Parsons guarantee.
Yes, all right, that is set in stone. Okay. Oh dear, that was sad.
No. No, never sad. You're great.
Okay, looks the same from the top but not from the bottom, so what have I done wrong? I know what I've done wrong.
Wow, this is not wanting to fill in. Sorry. It's not wanting to fill in. I'm like, come on, be a little higher, water. And it's like, I don't know.
if you try to put the water in the water, it will fail. Okay, the water will just get absorbed. What you've got to do is put it on the edges. It sounds weird, but...
No, I get you. Okay, I'll do that. I shall do. Yeah, okay. I get it now.
Great.
Yeah. Sorry. Apparently.
I'm just glad I know where that's come from now.
I've instilled this behavior in Simon, going, yeah. I feel really badly for all of you for having done this, because he's so posh and fancy and British, and I'm a ruiner.
just thinking about my background, where I came from. I'm so posh. Yes. No, yes.
I'm sure you. Yes, I'm sure that you would say that.
And very, very proud of the fact.
Well, that's good. Good to be proud of where you come from.
Yeah, I mean, I come from a rural background. I come from quite a simple background. I was catching up with an old school friend of mine a little while ago, and we were talking about bits and pieces. And I can't remember which one it was. Another zombie film had come out recently, and he was talking about that and how terrible it would be if the computers went away and we all had to live off our wits. And he just looked at me straight in the eyes and said, I don't mind, I can catch rabbits. Well, yeah, okay, you're sorted. And quite frankly, when the zombie apocalypse happens, if I happen to survive, you will probably end up being my king. So, yeah, go you, go you.
We'll see. I don't know. I would probably not last like 3 seconds. Although, to be fair to myself, I do have some restrictions which would make that problematic.
Yeah. This is true. And in my case, it's because I'm a lazy bugger.
Oops. Don't fall in.
Alright, so let's put that around the edge here. Oh yeah, that works. And then that's can then mark the start of the next roof, which will go up a bit. Nope, actually that one doesn't work. But the others do.
Hmm.
And I can build the wall out here, and I've still got my nice square pyramid, which is gonna come up. Oh look, the moon is gonna shine directly down it. That's great.
Good.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, come on, Philip. He's being a jerk now.
I want to get some lighting in here, which is not torches.
Yeah, we're going to have to fill this area out with some non-torch.
Great. Okay, so what we can do here is go tap into my limited supply of ghost glowstone.
How do you get glowstone?
You've got to go to the nether.
I see it on the ceiling. You just got to build up to the ceiling. And mm-hmm. That sounds awful.
Grab hold of the stuff. Yeah. Oh, it's loads of fun until you get knocked off by a ghast. But apart from that, it's loads of fun. Not sure how much glowstone I've got left. I've used a ton of it recently.
You're going to...
various builds. I've got one block of glowstone, so at least it gives a vague idea of what it looks like.
Is the bridge going to be...
Oh, off to the nether.
Is the bridge going to be built up a little bit over here?
No.
Because this... So I can keep the river lower.
No. Let's go up a step. These stairs down can become stairs up, and then the bridge can go across here and come back down again. Okay. It'll be perfectly fine, I think.
There we go.
And then, you can have a nice big rushy river. And
I mean, it kind of, with the way this is, it kind of just looks like it's much deeper in the middle than it actually is. But I'd like to get it where the physics kind of make more sense, but...
I can't actually hear the water rushing, but it's probably because I'm hosting the Skype call and it's muting my sounds. But hopefully it will come through in the video. Otherwise, just think hard of going to the toilet and you'll probably get the right sound.
Well, it does sound pretty.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like when your toilet runs.
Right, so what I'm going to do is these little square blocks here. Just stick some glowstone in, and that just casts a nice bit of light down here.